And on tonight's roundtable, learn how NYC comedians, which includes a Hommocks teacher, are helping the Center for Continuing Education.
Hello, I'm Sibylla Shibaziwa, and welcome to the roundtable. The Comedy Night fundraiser for the Center for Continuing Education is in its second consecutively. And that'll be held on Thursday, April 25th at Molly's. You'll be able to find out more about it because tonight I'm joined by Diane Cashman, who is the executive director of the LMCCE. Thank you for joining me.
Thank you, Sibylla.
Hommocks teacher by day, comedian by night, it's Ron Nobles. And we have New York City-based comedian who is Sasha Srbulj.
Thank you.
I told you I was going to get it right.
You got it.
Good job.
Thank you for joining me, the three of you. If you at home have any comments or questions, you can contact us. If you're watching on Facebook, you can leave a comment. Information is on your screen now. Now, Diane, I guess we'll start with you. What is the Center for Continuing Education? What does it do?
Okay, well, first, thank you so much for having us on The Local Live. This is a great opportunity for us. The Center for Continuing Education is a nonprofit organization based right here in Mamaroneck High School. We serve Southern Westchester, Larchmont, Mamaroneck, Rye, and many other localities around in this area. We are a little organization. Our roots date back 80 years, so we've been right here in Mamaroneck for 80 years. We were created by the school board to serve the first wave of immigrants coming from the European countries that didn't speak English. Since then, we have grown. We offer classes. In 1970, we were spun off and we became completely independent from the school system. So we are completely self-financing. We don't receive any funding from the school system. And we fund ourselves through class fees. We provide more than probably 300 classes a year to our community, wow. Over 2,000 students. We're about the size, if you think about that, it's about the size of Mamaroneck High School in terms of the number of
right.
students that we serve. But we do it on a very on a shoestring budget because we try to keep our class fees as low as possible to make it as accessible as possible to as many community members as we can. So we offer traditional continuing education like languages, ESL, arts classes. We offer back-to-work skills classes like Excel classes, social media. Recently, we've become engaged with school-age children in terms of we partnered with the STEM Alliance. We offer STEM programming, study skills, college prep classes, and we also bring cultural enrichment opportunities to the local community, either through trips to museums or we invite book authors to come. We like to feature in a Notable Neighbor series of prominent
right.
locals. And so that's a little bit about who we are. And we're very, very pleased. About a year ago, mm-hmm. When I took over the job, about a year and a half ago, I was sitting in my office looking at the computer screen in the Mamaroneck High School. And Debbie Bonetta, who works in the high school, produces
right.
a wonderful segment called Mamaroneck Minute, featuring local teachers in the high school and staff, and up pops Ron, this technology teacher who is a comedian by night, and I thought, wow, this is absolutely amazing. Who would have thought a technology teacher is, you know, this incredible comedian?
How did you get into teaching technology and, of course, being a comedian, but we can get to that.
I don't know if you want to dig in that deep into why I became a comedian, but...
not too deep, but first, I guess, yes, with teaching.
So, well, it's actually funny that I'm a teacher now, because when I was in high school, I won class clown.
Nice.
You know, probably a lot of my teachers, if they saw this segment right now, they'd be falling over. It'd be hard for them to believe that I'm now a teacher. And, you know, I told my parents, I think in fifth grade, hey, I'm going to be a comedian someday. You know, I grew up in Buffalo, so I'm going to move to New York City. I'm going to be a comedian. And they were like, where did you come up with this? And then I just kept sticking to my guns. So my parents were like, why don't you at least go get, you know, a degree, something to fall back on. And I always just loved technology and hands-on learning. And so that's kind of how I got into, you know, being a technology teacher. Mm-hmm. And when I graduated from college, I got my first teaching job down here. You know, I lived in the Upper East Side for a long time and started doing stand-up and kind of tied it all together. So I'm excited to perform for some parents. You know, I mean, their kids heckle me all day long. Now it's their parents' turn to do it. So this will be
How about you, Sasha? How did you I guess, get pulled into this? What piqued your interest?
In comedy or this particular?
Well, both.
Both?
But I guess, yeah, in comedy. Yeah, let's start there.
I saw Ron was doing it, and I thought, I'll do whatever he's doing. That was basically
that's a mistake in life.
Well, no, but I followed him, and I followed him here too. So everything is really I'm just piggybacking off of his
coming full circle.
Yeah.
So
coming full circle. Okay. Well, I guess we'll continue that conversation. We'll be right back after these messages. Stay tuned for more of the roundtable.
Do you need space for a meeting, conference, or presentation? LMCTV has what you need. Our 768 square foot studio space is ideal for many types of productions, readings, recitals, rehearsals, and workshops. The space has video recording capability, as well as daylight temperature lighting, green screen, and stage. Two additional rooms at 208 and 156 square feet can be used for any of your needs. Auditions, meetings, classes, workshops, one-on-one instructions, and more. Both rooms feature video monitors with Chromecasting capability, making presentations a breeze. To reserve one or more of our spaces,
contact us at reserve@lmctv.org.
So there you are, shuffling through a stack of resumes and you come to mine. This is it, first impression, my way in. But can my resume show you how I truly stand out? Like that I was studying, going to night school while working two jobs just to help my parents pay for groceries. Or being the first one to always step up. No, that's something you just can't put on paper. Look beyond the resume and discover new ways to develop great talent that is dedicated, hardworking, and determined like me.
Welcome back to the roundtable. We are now talking about the Comedy Night fundraiser, which is in its second year, partnership with the Center for Continuing Education. Ron, do you want to talk more about how you got into comedy and where we left off?
Yeah, absolutely. So when I first moved to the city, I actually started doing some work at the Comic Strip Live, which is, I guess they claim it's the oldest club in the city, but they fight with Dangerfields, isn't that true?
Yeah.
So just through doing some work from there, I worked my way up. I got passed on what they call late night, and that led to getting past the pro shows, and I was actually working that circuit that I ran into Sasha, and really a lot of my closest friends now are stand-up comics. So we're traveling all over the country together. Well, Sasha, you've traveled all over the world, right?
Yes. Yeah.
Where have you performed? And yeah, if you want to talk
in
more.
In English. Let me be clear. I'm not like performing in French and Spanish or anything.
Okay.
It's all in English. I don't want to like make people think I'm doing this in Japanese or anything.
Sure.
I've performed in Paris and Barcelona, Hong Kong, but again, all in English. So.
Well, he's found out that if his audience doesn't understand what he's saying,
yes,
he usually
better.
Does the best that way.
So. Oh. Yes. Some places are just happy to see somebody this hairy.
Yeah,
a lot of parts of Asia, this is an attraction.
Yeah. I hear you there. What about are your comedy styles similar? Are they different? Yeah, how would you describe
your style?
So
actually, I think that's one thing that's interesting about the way we set this show up, and I did it similar last year. So, I'm going to host again this year, but I brought all new comics to come with me. And what I really try to do is get people that have a ton of different flavors. So, we've got five comics. Every person's going to have their own style, their own unique set. Because I think, if you're going to sit through, an hour and a half with somebody, sometimes if that's not your style, you're like, oh, I'm over this. Ooh. So, Sasha and my style is way different. But yet, all the other comics have their own unique perspective. So I think there's going to be something for everybody when they come out. And we're all pros. I mean, everybody's done tons of work. Caitlin was just on the Colbert Show, right? John Ivorone, who's coming down, performs all over the place as a big-time headliner. Eric Newman, who's coming, he had the number one album on iTunes for a long time.
Yeah.
So, I mean, really accomplished guys. Ryan Brown, who tours all over and does big comedy festivals all over the place, is coming up, originally from North Carolina. So he's going to give you that southern perspective. And I think people from Larchmont are really going to relate to, so that should be good.
I can't wait. It was so much fun last year.
Yeah, it was, and it's going to be a cool show again. And like I said, all new comics. So if you came last year, come back out again this year, and you're going to get a whole new feel out there. Still laugh, though. Still laugh.
Yeah, it's going to be a city quality show. right in your backyard. So.
What do you mean by that?
What I mean is, you know, instead of taking the trek into New York City to see these guys, oh. they're going to be right here.
Right here, ready for you.
Ready for you.
Aside yeah. from Ron being involved in this, what made you want to participate
Ron.
In this, Sasha?
Ron made me want to
Aside
participate.
From Ron.
I've always been dedicated to continuing adult education. Forever. Like I said, we talked earlier, I consider half of the population functionally illiterate.
Right.
And I would think that they should get continual education. For, you know, so that's, I'm dedicated to it. And if there's anything I can do beyond this show to help.
Thank you so much, Sasha.
Well, and like there. Sasha, we were talking about on the way up here, you know, like love stories have happened because of
yes,
night school, right?
This
like
is a
Twilight. How are you going to meet a vampire? I mean, you'd have to go to night school to meet.
Exactly.
Right. So all you people, all you ladies out there that are looking for that great love story,
Twilight.
You're going to have to come to continuing education to
know.
Meet that person after the sun goes down.
Yeah, because I mean, the dark undertone of this whole segment is the hookup culture that happens at night school. I mean, this is before the apps. This was the only place.
Oh yeah, adults. We're involved, hopefully consensually.
Yeah,
I hear
obviously.
You.
Yeah, but it's very easy to make that transition from a pottery class to you want to get a drink, you know.
Yeah.
So that's another reason to join, I think, beyond, you
Absolutely.
Know, expanding
so,
the mind.
Sasha is joking.
I think you hit the nail right on the head.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
This is a little flavor of what's going to happen.
Mm-hmm.
But no, Sasha makes. It's a point he's making, but actually it's one of the points we emphasize a lot, you know, in this technology, increasingly techno-driven world, sorry, Ron. Coming to continuing edge is an opportunity for people to actually interact with each other, make eye contact, mm-hmm. share a joke, smile, talk. That's one of the very important aspects of the Center for Continuing Education. It's even more important now than it was pre-tech, in my opinion.
And robots are coming for your job. Everybody knows that.
So you might as well
continue
I guess.
The education.
True. So. How did this partnership come about?
With Ron and the center?
You said you saw him on the computer, on a profile, and then how did it get into a fundraiser?
You know, and they reached out to me and they said, hey, can you help us out and, you know, raise some money for this? And I thought about, you know, these poor finance guys working in, you know, that live in Larchmont, that you're going to need some life skills later here in life. I thought, I want to do all I can to help this organization raise some money. So I jumped right on board and got after
it. Okay.
Since he said that,
why do we actually even need to run a benefit at the Center for Continuing Ed? Well, over the past 80 years, and over the past 10 years, our community has really changed demographically. We have a big chunk of the community that is able to afford our classes and comes to our classes. But increasingly, we noticed that there were, particularly with the school-age children, there were families that couldn't really benefit from the classes that we offered, even though we really negotiate very competitive pricing. And so just this year, I'm glad you brought that up, just this year we launched a scholarship program.
Right.
And we're really proud of that because it's the first time in the history of the organization that we've done that. And we have offered 18 scholarships this year in between fall, winter, and spring. And in spring, just for the first time, we've expanded those scholarships to adults in the community that want to take our skills training courses to go back into the workforce. So we're really pleased that we can do that. And the only way we can do that, really, is through benefits like these. And so we're so grateful to Ron and to Sasha and to the comedians that are coming out here from New York to support us, because really without the support, this is really the only benefit we do. Every year, and it was so successful last year that the community came back to us and said, please do this again, we'd really love to do it.
Awesome.
And we've already sold half of our premium seats, which is amazing.
Heard
so,
that. All right.
Buy your seats, people.
All right, we'll be right back after these messages. Stay tuned for more of the Roundtable.
LMCTV Media Center is the spot for your next party. Lights, camera, liftoff. The possibilities are endless. Space adventures, video gaming, whatever they imagine LMC can achieve. Kids of all ages have fun making their own videos in our professional TV studio. LMC TV is the perfect spot for your creative kid to celebrate with friends and make a memory that will last forever in video. Party themes can range depending on their desire. Fun news shows, music videos, stop motion, overall silliness, our cameras can capture it all. Contact us to book a party today.
Maybe you can make retirement happen.
After all, you made her college years happen.
Achah. opening that education savings account when she was little, spearheading a campus tour, and another, and another, and another, and another. Bam! Deciphering financial aid. She was like, what? Well, now she's like, you aced planning for college. Now get the tips you need to get on track at aceyourretirement.org.
Welcome back. We are here with three people who are involved in the comedy fundraiser on April 25th for the Center for Continuing Education. And I wanted to ask about who you're partnering with. Molly's, why are you holding that event there yet again? If you want to comment on that, yes.
Yes, sure. So when we were first thinking about Comedy Night, the first time around, we were trying to think, we wanted to keep it local, and we wanted it to be in an environment that was a little bit, it was a benefit. We wanted it outside of our normal space that we typically use. And Molly has a very good setup for us, and as a nonprofit and a local organization, they were willing to work with us. Mm-hmm. So that we could hold the event there, and it was absolutely fantastic. So the ticket price actually covers this amazing performance with these New York City-based comedians, as well as dinner at Molly Spillane's, and then we have an open cash bar. And the wonderful thing is our very generous sponsors, Julia Beefy Sotheby's, are our premium sponsor. And so most of the proceeds that we raise will go directly to the programs and the scholarships that the center offers. Mm. So it's fantastic. It's just, it's got everything just kind of came together. It's a great partnership all the way around. And we love that Ron is a teacher in the school system helping a local organization. And we love that he brings in his friends. And we really love that he has really funny friends. So it's great.
That is great.
It's perfect.
How did you guys, get into comedy? What made it, what was that moment, I guess, one day that hit you? It was like, eureka.
All right, dig in on this one.
I was thinking about this. It doesn't.
Yes, Mr. Srbulj.
It's hard for me to answer this question because I don't really believe in free will.
Okay.
So, I don't know, why do we do anything? It's sort of the question I ask myself when you ask
me that. Why do we do anything?
So you're still going with this question. All right.
Yes. I want you to talk.
I don't know. I think, frankly, it's because I liked it my whole life. You know, since I was a kid, I liked stand-up comedians. Mm. And one day I decided to try it. And just to throw it back to continuing education, if you decided to try pottery and you liked it your whole life, see, great things can happen. So take a class. That's what I did. I took a comedy class.
Do you have a favorite comedian outside of Ron?
It's hard, like, next to Ron, he shines so bright.
Yeah.
It's hard to see any of the other surrounding stars, you know?
I don't even take you with me everywhere I go, Sasha. Yeah.
What has it been like getting ready for 3 weeks from now? Do you have any preparation
for us?
Per
well,
se?
I'm planning on, like, right before I get on stage, writing down my jokes. That was my plan.
Very, very much stream of consciousness.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
No, I think most comedians have a set, and they're working on, and you leave, like, I mean, I don't want to take away from the surprises of it, but a lot of it is prepared, and then you leave some time for improvisation, and that's.
Yeah, I think because I'll be hosting that day, so really your job as a host is, and, you know, I come out, you know, being a teacher in the community, I'm going to be pretty, tame, if you will. But I will come out and just feel out the audience for different types of humor and what they're kind of into, and really the comics will be backstage watching the host, watching the early comics, and kind of adjusting their set to what people are really into that night and what they think is funny. So most of our jokes are, pre-prepared. Obviously, during your set, you'll talk to the crowd, and if you can think of something funny to come up with at that time and that it's going to spark with the crowd, you use it. But the comics, and the later you go on the show, it's the advantage you have, right? Because you're like, oh, they're into this. So comics are kind of constantly changing their set for, what this audience is going to be into. And
can you draw any parallels from being a comedian to teaching?
Well, I'm a middle school teacher. I don't know how last time you've been around middle school kids, but they are a way tougher crowd than a New York City comedy audience. I can tell you that right now. But no, I mean, really, my teaching style is I'm messing around with the kids. I'm trying to have, a pretty good time with them. I think that's so key. Yeah. Even in education, like, your teachers that really had the biggest impact in you, I bet they used a lot of humor, in their instruction, because it keeps you going. It keeps you halfway awake. You're making kids sit here for 40 minutes or whatever it is.
Or
so
people,
I think it's changed. It doesn't matter how old you are, really. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So I do think it's an important aspect to teaching.
Great. So, Diane, like you had mentioned earlier, operating on a shoestring, I'm sure this is a great creative way to tap into some funds. Do you agree? I mean, has this always been a way that the center has tried to raise more money, or?
No, in fact, typically the fundraising and the Comedy Night fundraiser, we launched it last year, and we are not the kind of organization that we have typically done a lot of fundraising. But when we spun off from the school system mm-hmm. in the 70s, we had to be self-financing. And then about 10 years ago, we were required to pay for all of our space, everywhere that we use that. And it's just very, very difficult to keep up with costs without raising class fees to the point that you're really excluding people from taking the classes. And so really fundraising is the only way to be able to do that, to be able to offer the high quality classes and experiences that we offer at prices that make it as affordable to as wide a range of the community as we possibly mm-hmm. can. And then on top of that, we really do need to be offering scholarships to people that that need them. And so that's another reason that we need to hold fundraisers now.
Right.
It's a new era for us.
It is. Well, thank you again for joining me. The Comedy Night fundraiser will be held again Thursday, April 25th from 7 to 10 at Molly's. You can visit the website of the Larchmont-Mamaroneck Center for Continuing Education, which is lmcce.org, for tickets and more information. Thank you so much, Diane, Ron, and Sasha for joining me tonight. And thank you for watching. Stay tuned for more of The Local Live.